I'll let you in this time.
1, 2, 3. Woohoo!
Jennifer for giving me the opportunity to say some remarks. There are three people I don't pick a fight with. One is my wife, for obvious reasons, and the other two are Wendy and Pete. On the matter of the disputed lands, let's just say how honored I am to be here in the Robinson-Superior Treaty, this magnificent land we call home, Northwestern Ontario, our shared lands with more opportunity than we could ever imagine. And I think this project sets the standard for that in so many significant ways. For those of you who are not from Northwestern Ontario, we actually don't think 500 kilometers is a terribly long way. But it is in the context of what we've achieved. It's more than just a physical piece of infrastructure. We've brought communities together, municipalities, indigenous communities. We've brought the opportunity for economic development and resource-based industries to thrive on the prospect that this energy corridor lives up to everything that we believe it can and it will. Bamkushwada, God, I love that name. Nobody's been able to tell me what it means yet, but Supercom are the ways that we should be thinking about how we do business in Northwestern Ontario. I know we have our other more traditional partners, and we appreciate them. The NextBridge project, the East-West Tie, as it's called, is really about ensuring that all of our communities and all of the economic opportunities that go with it for the benefit of our youth will be here for generations to come. So the role of the Ontario government, certainly this one in the past little over a year, has been to cut red tape, to get regulatory matters out of the way once they are reasonably settled in reasonable timelines, and push this project across the goal line. I'm getting ready for the hockey season myself there. So importantly, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here today. The celebration started about 6 or 7 months ago in Fort William First Nation, and to see the enthusiasm, to know that 450 kilometers and 300 young Indigenous peoples would be gainfully employed on this project, our government understood the pressure and some had the opportunity. And someone who lives out there very much in every part of Northwestern Ontario and the opportunities that we have here to get this project going. So thank you very much for this opportunity. I'm Greg Rickford. I'm the member of Provincial Parliament for the Great Kenora Rainy River. It's a privilege and an honor to serve my constituents and as the Minister of Energy, Northern Development and Mines, and Indigenous Affairs to serve you too. Congratulations to everyone and thank you for this opportunity.
Table, but you know, Sean is representing your community well. Chief Musquash, always nice to be here. I know you've been around for a couple of years only, but still nonetheless, you put a lot of work and effort into where we are here today. Chief Tanji, I know you're always instrumental in where we are. You and Chief Joanne, I mean, we use you for just lifting our world up and lifting us up in a great way every day when we start our meetings. So I thank the women of our board and knowing the contribution that they have made to making sure that our next generation has an input, has an impact, has success in the journey that we have to work on together. You know, and the industry has to understand when they come into our territories, we're not here for a handout. We're here with our hands to be a hand up and making sure that the success of our next generation has an impact, and our economies and our communities can grow from industry opportunities similar to this. And we want to make sure that the work that we have done over the last couple of years will lead into generational impacts and success for our community and our community members. A lot of our folks in our community, our contractors, they're waiting to put their shovel in the ground or put their footprint on the ground of this project for themselves, for their family, so they have a great life and a great income for their community. So on behalf of my board, Minister Rickford, my friend, my colleague, you know, we shared in the excitement of your government helping push the umbrella and making sure that we never lost this project and make sure that this project is where it is at today. So on behalf of my board rep and all the reps that I work with, I shouldn't say my board reps, to all my partnering communities, our partnering communities. We welcome you all here to our land. We hope that this leads a new generation of opportunities for our members and our communities. So on behalf of all of us, we thank you all.